Hi, and welcome to this Tech Insights video. My name is Mary, and I'm an application engineer here at IFM Effector. In today's video, we are going to go over the initial setup of an IFM industrial display controller. So let's get started. So here you have an IFM 7-inch CR1077 display. And in the corner of your screen, you can see the CR's power cable, which is part number E70450. This power cable has an M12 connector on it, and that is how you will connect it to 24 volts DC. One thing to note is that out of the box, the CR does not have a firmware loaded onto it. Therefore, when you power it up, it'll immediately take you to the recovery app page. However, in this example, our CR already has a firmware loaded to it. So in order to get to that recovery app page, while powering it up, you need to hold any of the three push buttons on the right-hand side. So let me show you how to connect the M12 connector to 24 volts DC while holding the three push buttons on the side. So now you can see it is powering it up. And here you have the recovery app page. These displays have dual IP addresses. You can see the factory set IP address in the recovery app page here. As you can see, the Ethernet 0 port's factory set IP address is 192.168.82.247. And the Ethernet 1 port's factory set IP address is 192.168.83.247. You can easily upload the firmware of these displays using the display's web browser. In order to connect to the web browser, you'd use the M12 to RJ45 connection and take it from the display to your PC. So now let's navigate to the web browser so we can show you what that looks like. Before we can navigate to the web browser for the display, you need to make sure that your PC's IP address matches the domain of your display's IP address. To do this, you need to go into your network and internet settings. Then you will go to your network and sharing center. Then you will go into your Ethernet settings and press properties. Then go to internet protocol version 4, and you will enter this IP address, 192.168.82.200. And make sure your subnet mask is set to 255.255.255.0 and hit OK. Now that your PC's IP address matches the domain of your display's IP address, you can go to a web browser and enter the IP address of your display, which is 192.168.82.247, and you need to hit set :8080 and press enter. And now you can see the web browser for your display. So now that you are connected to the web browser, you need to find the firmware file to upload to your display. You can find this at our website. So now let me take you to the website and show you where to navigate on our website to find that file. At our website, in the search term bar, you will enter the part number of your display. In this video, we are using the CR1077. When you pull up that part number, you will click on the part number in the orange font to get to the full data sheet. And if you scroll down, you will go to downloads. Make sure you are signed into your MyIFM account and go below the software for the Ecomat display. Here you will find the firmware and you can press download. Now that you have downloaded and unzipped your firmware file, you need to navigate to the .swu file. Once you find this file, you will drag and drop it into your web browser page for your display. And now you can see that the firmware is being loaded onto the display. As you can see, the firmware has finished downloading to the display. You will now press restart in the web browser, and next I am going to take you to the display and show you how to manually set the IP address using the touch screen. So now that you have your firmware loaded onto your CR display, let me show you how to change some of the basic settings. As we noted earlier in the video, these displays have dual IP addresses. However, you can use it with a single IP address, and let me show you how to do that. You will go into your Launch Setup section, you will click on Connection, and you will click on Bridge and Ethernet. Here you can see bridge mode is turned off, and you can see you have your Ethernet zero port properties parameters, and you have your Ethernet 1 parameters. If you click on bridge mode and turn it on, you will now have a single IP address, and this is where you can change and set it, as well as your network map, your net mask setting, and your gateway settings. So then if you like what you set, you can press the save button, and then you will hit the back arrow until you're back at your main display. You can also set up your controller's date and time by going into this system setup section and date and time. Here you can set up your time zone and what time zone you are in by using the drop-down windows. And you can also set up your exact system time with the year, month, date, and time. When you have that set to what you'd like it set for, you'd press the save button again, and then you would press the back arrow, and you'd keep pressing it, and you would press this power button, and yes, to get back to the main display so that you can launch your application. And that concludes this Tech Insights video on the initial setup of our IFM industrial display controllers. As always, you can find more helpful information at our IFM website, or you can email into info.us@ifm.com or call into 1-800-441-8246 to speak with somebody who can assist you. Thank you for your time and have a great day.